feel the power? Can you feel the power? Feel the power of Double XI. Worldwide Podcast. You are listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide Podcast.
Hey, 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 my name is Davis and I'm from Haiti, but I'm living in Dominican Republic. I'm here, Positive Power 21, Jerry Royce Live Worldwide.
All right, what's going on, family? Family, what's up? It's me, Jerry Royce Live Worldwide, aka the Batman of Charm City. Right here, y'all. That's right, it's hot, y'all, like that hot ATL. Apologies. Thank you for joining us, and we're so happy for you guys to be partaking a little bit of podcast with us. If you were just tuning in to the Lakeisha Mosey Show, she had Mr. Podcast himself, Ron E. Jefferson. He has released, two books. You can catch him on Amazon. Just go out to Amazon.com, look for Ron E. Jefferson. He has some powerful books out there right now, and I think you would really appreciate it, especially if you're trying to learn a little something about the male. That's right, the male population. Also, don't forget about Paula G. She also have a book out there on Amazon. It's called Lady Wisdom After Midnight. Check her out. It's a good book. And also, Lakeisha Mosey. I think she has several books out there on Amazon, so check her out, too. So you got Lakeisha Mosey, Paula G. The Voice, and Ron E. Jefferson. That's right. The podcast is doing their thing. Also, you can also find... That's right. Late Night with Jerry Royce Live Worldwide on Pray.com. That's right. We're syndicated out there on Pray.com. Wonderful looking website. You find a lot of celebrity and major mainstream speakers out there. And the site is just growing and growing. Major investors. So check it out. Y'all, it's a lot to it. You have to subscribe in order to listen to any of the podcasts or any of the Bible stories that's carried on their websites. I think the site is actually set up in three tiers, but it's a good subscription. You really appreciate it. Great stuff out there. All right. Of course, you can find us on Spreaker Radio. That's right, Spreaker.com. Just look for Jerry Royce Live. And also, you can find us on Periscope. That's right, streaming right now. If you go out to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide, that's right, on Facebook page, you will find us. And you can just click any one of those links, and it will take you where we're podcasting live. So if you listen to us right now, you're already there. It's good for you. Also, if you're just on demand, a lot of you guys are 6 to 8 hours ahead of us. And we appreciate all our overseas listeners. You guys are so awesome. And especially the artists, because they always inbox it. Batman, when can you play my music video on your TV show? When can you play my music? Yeah, I got you guys. I got you. You got to give me time, y'all, to put it together, because, you know, we only play the music mostly on the weekends, but we do introduce it on our shows if you're a guest. So a lot of you overseas guys, please work hard on trying to get yourself on the Skype so we'd be able to, you know, to get you into our call system, because we can't get you on the call system on WhatsApp. I do not use WhatsApp. I'm still trying to figure out what it is. I tried it before and I didn't like it. I had to delete it. So anyway, so we have a great guest tonight. He's no stranger. He was on Late Night before with Kelly Rowland. We had a great time with him. His name is Brother Al. I like to call him Big Al, but his given name on his artist label is Big Al. And we're going to get a chance to talk to him for a minute. But let me talk to Paula G. She will be doing an interview. Paula G, The Voice, what's up? What's up? How you doing? You holding up in the heat?
I am fabulous. Jerry Royce Live Worldwide. Well, you know, down here in Hotlanta, we just have to hang in there and maintain and deal with it, because it's almost year round down here. This heat is almost, ooh, Lord. It's almost year round down here, but you know, it's all good. We're battling a few things. You know, we got some challenges going on with, you know, our
you're under
current
construction.
Worldwide situation.
That's right.
And yeah, and then, you know, last Friday, I'm gonna tell you, last Friday was rough here in Atlanta, because we lost Reverend C.T. Vivian in the morning, on Friday morning,
yeah.
And then later that evening we lost Congressman John Lewis.
Yeah.
So Atlanta's we're struggling this week. We're struggling, yeah, but
remarkable,
we're
man.
Holding on. We're holding on.
Yeah, remarkable.
Yes,
man.
Yes. Just a mighty march. I went down to, was it last Sunday? It was last Sunday. They had a candlelight vigil for John Lewis downtown on Auburn Avenue, which is a historical area here in the Atlanta area. It's where Ebenezer Baptist Church is. It's where the King family lived. And there's a mural of John Lewis. And it was just beautiful, all of the tributes and the flowers and the signs and the pictures. And so it was a beautiful evening. I put a little video together and put it up on my page to honor, you know, Congressman John Lewis.
He's very powerful, man.
Hashtag
powerful.
Good trouble.
Yeah, that's right. Good trouble.
He said getting some good trouble.
Yeah, that was a powerful movie too. You know, they did that piece on Selma. That was a powerful movie. And it was it was good to see that he was able to see, you know, his work, you know, he worked so hard, you know, with the in the middle of the Black Lives Matter movement. He was able to take that in, you know, take his final walk. So that was powerful.
He put together three books or graphic novels, which basically boils down to, you know, most of us would consider them comic book type books, but there were three books, they were graphic novels, and I had the opportunity to record all three for the Georgia Radio Reading Service, which, you know, some of you know is the radio station for the blind and visually impaired. But it was a challenge because, you know, with graphic novels, you have to describe to the listener, to the visually impaired audience, describe what is going on the pages of the book, but yet not give away the suspense. You know, you give them enough that they can, you know, get an idea of what's going on, but not so much that you're giving away what's going on. That makes sense. But that was just a powerful journey, because there were times where I had to kind of stop when I was recording it and just catch myself, because the sketches and the drawings were so graphic, and the description of what was going on, because it really took you across that bridge on Bloody Sunday.
Yeah.
You know, it really took that journey and the other journeys as well. So, yeah, just powerful, powerful,
right.
Powerful.
We'll probably see some more on that Bloody Sunday. You know, what was so fascinating watching that memorial today, got a chance to catch it on YouTube live, and also I was watching on Periscope at the same time. That was a remarkable journey that, you know, that his life took, and for this period right now, we're in COVID-19. So many people did not get the proper memorial, you know, homegoing service. I was just thinking about my son's grandmother, how much she had given to this earth herself, and you know, she wasn't able to get maybe a third of the church, and basically all of us tried to get there, you know, that Friday before the service. I mean, it was Friday. The service was Saturday. And it was just, we had to watch it on Facebook, you know, and it just wasn't, to me, it wasn't her proper home going, because she's given so much to Christianity, because she had so many people just look, you know, some people can just look at them and say, wow, she's close to God, man. I gotta watch her, you know, because people always questioning God all the time. But this lady, she was an earth angel for sure. But then watching this man, you know, for all he had done for mankind and civil rights and African Americans and people of other colors too, to see him sent off like that, you know, was a good feeling, you know.
Right.
During this midst of this COVID-19.
Yeah, but you're right. I mean, there's so many that, you know, so many families that have not gotten proper closure, you know, a lot of personal, you know, families have not gotten proper closure, because, you know, it was good to see Congressman Lewis, you know, get that send off today, because, you know, CT Vivian last week, they had a small private service, so that was televised as well. But even Dr. Lowry, Reverend Joseph Lowry as well, you know, passed earlier on, and he too was not able to really, they were not able to give him, you know, really a proper send off. So I hope at some point in time, you know, these gentlemen, plus all of us who have been touched, who have who have lost loved ones, at some point in time, we can all come together and get that proper closure, because that's huge.
Yeah, that's huge. Especially, you know, celebrating them, you know, maybe hopefully in a year or two, we can do that, because it's a shame, because there's some people you would want to hear say some touching things, how that person affected their life. That affects people when they're sitting, you know, it could be a wedding, it could be a funeral, you know, it's going to affect somebody sitting there who don't have no direction at the time. Certain words, you know, kind of encourage you and say, oh, wow, man, I need to pull my bootstraps up myself, you know, get it moving.
Getting that closure. Yeah.
That's right. Yeah. All right. Well, I think this guy, Big Al, can help us put things in perspective. He has a wave of words. Very intelligent young man. He has great artwork on his website of himself. I said, well, I need to get some artwork done. Not just photography, but the graphics that's on his website is really, really good. I actually posted a couple of them on the flyer for people to see. Big Al, Brother Al, what's up, my man? What's going on?
Hey, look, I'm glad to be back on here, Brother Al, at your service. How y'all doing tonight?
Yes, sir. All right. Well, you have the pleasure this time of being interviewed by the great Paula G. How'd that feel?
Yeah.
That's right. He met Kelly. That's right. He met Kelly. So now you get to meet Paula G. But look, I'm just going to stand by and enjoy the interview, man. You guys have a great time. And Paul, let me know when you're ready to play the music. Amen.
All right. Amen. Amen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome to Late Night Radio with Jerry Voice Live and Paula G. right here on Positive Power 21. I know you can feel the power, and I know that you're going to like, you're going to share, you're going to go back and listen to this episode, as I know you all do with each and every episode. And I just want to remind you all to tune in each and every evening for the Triple Podcast, Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday, or Thursday night. Doesn't matter which night, any night, all of the nights, make sure that you tune in for some powerful podcasts, powerful conversation, powerful ministry, and powerful music, just like we have this evening with my guest. As Batman said, he is no stranger here to Positive Power 21. So, Robot, help me put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for Brother Al. My brother, what woke you up this morning?
Health and strength. Because that's the only way I was able to stay up. Amen. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what that's right about that. Talk about it.
Well, I know that's right.
Hey, nothing but the good Lord, but I needed the health and strength to stay up. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. I tell everybody, the fact that I woke up every morning, that's a blessing right there. That's a blessing. Yeah. That's a blessing in itself. It is. Well, tell us a bit about Brother Al. Who is Brother Al?
Oh, Brother Al is a nobody. I am just a vapor here to do the Lord's work for my little time I'm here on earth. You know what I'm saying? I consider my ministry and everything else I do to just be my reasonable service. And if everything I do is for me first. And if y'all happen to be blessed by it, then amen and amen. Rest of
amen.
It, all, you know.
Amen.
That's it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, what is some of the gifts that God has placed in you that you are using to reach his people?
The music is first and foremost. I'm not one genre specific. I take my liberties within that. And then I run a small ministry called Workshop for the Soul, in which I exhort and provide exhortations and things of that nature. I don't preach. I'm more of a teacher than a preacher. If teaching should get you more excited than preaching does, because it should cause your soul to feel like you learned something. But when you're stirred by teaching, then you then you come to love the Word of God. I love to walk away from something. I like Bible study more than I like Sunday service. That makes sense?
Mm-hmm. It does.
Okay.
It does. So how do you feel that the manner in which you teach, that it resonates with others? What is it about your teaching that you feel resonates with others?
Application. Come on now. See, a lot of folks will tell you what thus saith the Lord, but they don't teach application.
Mm-hmm.
Because mm-hmm. to teach application, you have to live it.
Right.
Other than that, we can all generally preach the word of God. We all call, right? But the gift that God has given me is to be able to provide common everyday application.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's what's missing. So I could tell you, be slow to speak. But if I don't tell you what moments that pop up that causes you not to be slow to speak, how will you keep your eye on it once you leave or once you tune off?
Mm-hmm.
So I could tell you, hey, you could hear from the man of God saying, y'all watch your mouths, you know. Everybody agree, right. Amen and amen. But mm-hmm. we know to watch our mouths, but in what moments do we need to look for? What must I be conscious of? And that's where Brother Al at Your Service come in. That's what I do. I try to provide application. I ain't going to tell you to shut your mouth, and then I tell you that your mouth is not able to get out of order when you're hungry, thirsty, mm-hmm. when you're too excited, when you're too sad. Those are the times in which you need to be slow to speak. And don't let the devil tell you because you're so excited, you can't have a good time because you know you may slip and cuss. Don't let them tell. Don't let them kill your time. No. Dial it down some. You know, your sin is still in your members. Mm-hmm. Dial it back just a little bit. It's not going to kill the fun, but it'll save you some embarrassment.
Yeah, being real with it. What you just shared is so, and I want to sit there for a minute because what you just shared is missing at times, you know. It's all about the application. We can memorize all day long. As you said, we can preach all day long, but it is the application of it. You know, if someone is experiencing suicidal ideation and you telling them, you know, just pray. At that moment, they might not necessarily hear, just pray. They need that application. They need something applicable, tangible at that moment to get them off that ledge, just like what you were saying, to get them off that ledge, you know, and then at that point, because I used to tell my students all the time, you know, suicide is a permanent solution to a temporary problem, you know, and just being able to give them something that's applicable that they can use in the moment is so huge. So I thank you for sharing that. Because I think a lot of people tend to miss that point.
Yeah, and I believe it, that ekes over into my music as well. I think you should be able to stay encouraged. That's what got me into it. I was closing my car though. And I realized the music, the Christian hip hop I was listening to, wasn't sticking with my spirit. The gospel music I was listening to wasn't sticking with my spirit. So when I close my car door and go into work, what's sticking with me? Right? So I started making music to encourage myself. I'm a big component. My next album coming out soon in October is called Reset the Church. So in order to reset the church, it starts with me. So I can't complain about the hole in the ship if I ain't doing my part to fill it. And I can't, I won't complain about the hole in the ship if I'm filling it. I'm too busy doing my part. How can I complain?
Right. You know, that really parallels in my head. It's a quote that I have utilized from, I think, the first time I got in front of a microphone on a show that I had on another network.
Okay.
And, you know, audience has heard it before. Greatest conversation that you will ever have is the one that takes place in between your ears. What are you speaking to yourself? Is God a part of that conversation? And are you listening to his still small voice? So what you just said in regard to, you know, resetting, you gotta reset yourself before you can, you know, step out and encourage or reset somebody else. And if the music that you're hearing was not ministering to you, then you had to go inside yourself and create that space, you know? And the fact that you had the gift of music to be able, you know, to create, to do, because it sounds like you had that conversation in between your ears, and to be able to have that conversation, and out of that conversation, okay, I got it right inside here. Now, let me take what I've learned and then minister, am I on the right track?
Yeah, absolutely. But I needed permission first. I was a little ashamed at first because I felt like this music is private for me. I'm making music to encourage myself, but y'all know it's too private and personal for everybody. It's too intimate at that time. And God gave me the confidence and to through confirmation through a sinner. He said, why don't you put this out? You know, I was like, nah, I'm not going to put this out. It's just for me.
Right.
And his words echoed with me later. And I got back home from Chicago, came back to Savannah, Georgia, and I prayed about it, and God gave me confirmation. So I've been putting out these records since 2015, 2016, and here I am today.
But you did the self-work first. That's huge.
Yeah.
You did the self stuff first, and that's the part that I think a lot of people miss, you know, and then out of that experience and out of that journey, then is birth, you know, kind of reshaping that music a little bit so that it can speak to the, you know, speak to the masses. When you see how your teaching, let's start with that first. When you see how your teaching affects others, or how it manifests in others, and when you plant those seeds and you see how that person begins to grow, what does that do for you? And I know it's not about, you know, I know it's not about you, it's what the Lord places. I got that. But what does that do for Brother Al?
It further cements in my mind why he saved me. Because a lot of times, especially when you say for a long time, if you're not busy doing the Lord's work, you can get lost as to why you've been saved. You can get lost as to what the goal was, because you ain't busy doing the work of the Lord. So there are not enough fruitful things, spiritually speaking, to reignite your fire for the Lord, to remember what your job is, what your reasonable service is. So that's what it does for you.
Wow. What would you say that at whatever point, and you don't necessarily have to verbalize that point, but if there was a point in your life that was very dark, shall we say, what was that conversation in between your ears that helped to pull you out of that space? And you don't necessarily have to share the experience.
Yeah. No. I wasn't raised on the once saved, always saved. I understood very well that I could lose it, and that God wouldn't give up on me, but I would quit God and deceive myself. What brought me out of that dark place was the fact that I was giving my testimony amongst ungodly men in my ungodly state, telling them who I used to be.
Giving your testimony. Wait a minute. Say that again. Give your testimony. Say it again.
Okay. So I was giving my old testimony to ungodly men as I was being ungodly, because I had walked away from the Lord. But all I could think about was all what I walked away from while having a good time. You understand that? So I couldn't help it. Because I realized that I had been bamboozled. Once I backslid and walked away from God, I realized that I traded gold for spray-painted bricks that looked like gold. And I realized gold in my hair. I realized it. And it hurt me because I couldn't just get saved when I wanted to get saved. God wasn't calling me. I knew I wanted to be back. I knew I wanted to live right. I had the desire, but I couldn't push the button because I ain't hear the call. It wasn't strong enough for me to want to stop doing what I was doing. And one day I was laying in the hospital, and they couldn't figure out what was wrong with me. And they were running tests and everything else, and I'm like, yo, something not right, yo. Y'all need to figure this out. And Holy Ghost said, you ready? Now, I have been waiting about a year and a half maybe for this call, and I heard it, and it brought me to tears. He said, you ready now? And I was like, oh, yeah. So then the nurse come in, she tell me something else, she lead back out. I say, never mind. I got to go. I know what's wrong. And I repented on that gurney, and I have been running for my life ever since. I got up, left all the test results and everything. They couldn't figure out nothing anyway. I know what was wrong. I couldn't tell you if I didn't accept it right then. If I didn't repent and accept Christ again right then, I would be here today. And how much more so the lives God has blessed me to touch and the souls God has blessed me to reach.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm supposed to be here. This is
such
my
a
job.
Time. Mm-hmm. And he's brought you through everything that he's brought you through.
That's
and
right.
left Look. You in some places for a moment in order to bring you to where you are. Exactly. But that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, though. Left
right.
you there because you weren't, like he said earlier, you weren't hearing. I think he said earlier he was speaking to you. At least this is what I got. He was speaking to you, but you weren't quite hearing it. So, therefore, you were kind of in that space for a minute. Until you could hear that still small voice, if I'm understanding what you said earlier,
the call
correct,
just
you know,
come.
Just,
I was just doing my thing with the remembrance of who I was, and one day God put me on my back and stuff, and that situation, he could have been talking the whole time, but because I was still up, I couldn't hear it, and it was on my back. You know, that's all you got to do for me. You mess with my health, I'm oh Lord, what. What have I done wrong? Some folks you mess with their health and they get better.
Yeah.
And they don't change. They get worse. God know how to pull my button, push my button. I'm trying to tell you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I get a cold too long. I can't shake the cold too long. Whoa, hey, soul sir, what have I done? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But if I thought I had more chances to be playing, I'll be playing. You understand that?
Right.
If I thought I had no time to be playing, I'd be playing with it. I'm only going this hard because I realize I have no more chance. I am fresh out of chance. I have full well tasted the salvation of the Lord. I know fully well what I do.
Right. And this is it. This is it. Wow. We're going to pause right there. When we come back from the break, we're going to listen to a little music. But when we come back from the break, I want to talk a little bit about how you have been navigating this season of the pandemic, the racial injustice and so forth, and how you've been navigating the season. But right now, we're going to take a break. Batman, I think you have some music for us. What's on tap?
Yeah, we got some music. It's called Got a Seal by Brother Al.
All right.
By God, scratch my name.
Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. Prepare for the day, evil hate my light though, huh? Persecution came when I let that light show, huh? Enemy of Christ, still he spared your life though, huh? Thief in the night, here to snuff your life though. It's a blessing, it's the way that life go. Got it back tenfold, just for slanking Christ though. You would live in sacrifice, that's the
life go. Said 1 hour at a time, marathon tight, bro. God said it any minute, ain't no scripture type.
Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. You full again, that mark your friend. The beast gon' keep you fed though, you follow Christ your whole life. The kind of Jesus that loves your sins. He over here, you ran over there to shake the devil's hand. You sealed forever, and death won't catch you. You fight against God's plan. I'm sealed, baby. King Jesus made me.
Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show.
Well, all right.
That's right.
Well, all right. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about that.
That record.
How that came
made,
to be.
Yeah. I made the record before I signed the record deal. And the God blessed me with that record, I think end of January, early February, if I'm not mistaken. And I made it just doing what I usually do. Didn't have any idea that people would be holding signs in Texas talking about we ain't going to take the mark at the beginning of COVID and all the rest of that. I knew it's an end time song. And it's to that song is designed to like provoke end times confidence amongst believers. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
As a reminder. So this record may not be for me, but it may be for my children or my grandchildren. And they play the record that provides them the end time confidence for that time. See, a lot of things we do, it may not be for the season, but for who needs it, is there. I mean, granted, it's applicable here. Don't get it wrong.
Right.
It's applicable here, but the song has multiple meanings.
Yes, absolutely. And I think when, you know, God places music inside of you, when he places those lyrics inside of you, it is for such a season, and sometimes we don't realize the season, you know, until it's upon us, and it can be humbling sometimes. So speaking of seasons, we have been in the last several months in a season like no other. How have you been navigating with the pandemic, social injustice? How have you managed to navigate?
Let's deal with the pandemic first, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I thought this was going to happen as soon as the 400 years hit anyway. But it hit the following, hit in 2020. The difference is that we in the Let My People Go season. We've served our time. The Bible says the nations whom you will serve will I judge, and afterward you shall come out with great substance. It also echoed that in Acts, which means it hadn't happened yet.
Yes.
Right. So if something says something in Genesis, and then it's repeated in Acts because it hasn't happened, then that wasn't for that time. That wasn't for their season. It was for ours. The things that God was explaining to Daniel, that Daniel wasn't getting, and God was like, yo, shut up the book, yo. But he ain't getting it. It's for this time. And so when you say, well, the pandemic, I look at it and I say, well, this is a lot different from the Exodus of a different time. Because where there's no Gosha for us. You understand that? There's the children of Israel, let's say, bust in every day to work, but we were in the suburbs of Gosha, not directly in Egypt. You know what I'm saying? So,
right.
The right amongst now, we are scattered amongst our enemy. And anybody, how I dictate who my enemy is, anybody who doesn't do the will of my father is not my brother. You understand that? Who is my brother? Who is my sister? Those who do the work of do the will of my father, right? So it's easy for me to identify who my people are, spiritually speaking, and then we have a natural people. I look at this time as the judgment season that it is. A lot of people will say, well, this is man-made. Who told you God can't use something man-made and apply it on man?
Exactly.
What biblical judgment handbook have you been reading out of that says he has to work the same way every time? You know?
Right.
And I look at it and I say, okay, the Bible says, for a man foreseeth evil and hideth himself. Right? But the foolish pass on and are punished. So I say, well, Lord, how can I hide myself in this season? Well, it's very clear. Don't do nothing unnecessary. It's as simple as that. And whatever you do, you have to do in faith.
Yes.
That's the blood on your doorpost.
Mm-hmm. Come on now.
How can you have yourself in this season? Wear your mask. People see me because they thought, oh,
that's the
people
blood
in China.
Yes.
Yeah. The people in China have been wearing masks. That's right. Mm-hmm. People in China have been wearing masks for smog for years. They've been okay.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So now all of a sudden we got to wear a mask and it's a problem?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
It's a 40-day journey that's going to take us 40 years because of the unwillingness, the disobedience, the lack of discipline and the lack of discernment and the lack of what you just said, understanding the doorpost.
Yeah.
Understanding the doorpost. The mask is the doorpost.
Sorry.
What you have over your doorpost? Absolutely,
so
absolutely.
I look at it that way, but I also see it as a thinning of the herd process because God said He would gather His children from the four corners of the earth, even the islands from whence they were dispersed. I only know one people who were dispersed even to the islands, right? The issue is that he said he was only pulling out a remnant. So a lot of us got to die, if that's the case, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Or a lot of us
will
stay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And say better it was in Egypt. Huh?
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
So it's either a lot of us getting ready to we'll stay when it's time to leave, or a lot of us are getting ready to die because he said he's only pulling out a remnant.
Right. Yeah. Huge, huge. Powerful, powerful. If you could go back to a time where, as you had alluded to earlier, you weren't in a position to hear God's voice. Is that fair? Mm-hmm. Is that fair to say? Okay.
Oh, I was in
sin. And you could sit.
Yeah, the sin was clouding my ears from here.
Uh-huh.
Sure.
Okay. If you could sit in front of that man or boy at whatever season, whatever point that was at, what would you speak to him, or would you speak to him? Would you have to jack him up? What would you do?
I leave him alone. He needed everything he got to run for his life. I got to trust the process. I wouldn't interfere with that man. I leave him alone. If anything I could do, it would be to convince that man that he needs to be saved as a child and show him how much easier life would be if he obeyed as a child and served God as a child faithfully and then grew in knowledge. Then I would, that's the only thing I would tell him is, bro, you got to get this now. Like, I know it looks like you got an option.
Right.
But you ain't got an option.
It looks like.
About the, you know what I'm saying? It looked like you.
Yeah.
Bro. You,
right.
You belong to the Lord, bro. You got to do this now.
But.
Right. Yeah. So it's either I would stop him as a child or I wouldn't do anything. I'd leave him alone.
Wow. Wow, that's huge. I love that answer, and that's the first time I believe I have gotten an answer like that, that I would just leave them alone and trust the process. Wow. Wow. Now, you know, we only have a couple more minutes, so I'm getting distracted here because I understand that you are a native of Chicago.
That's correct. That's correct. I'm a Grand Hospital baby on the north side.
Okay, so if I'm understanding correctly, that you can't come out of Chicago without, you know, knowing how to step just a little bit.
I tell you what. No, that most of us have entertained that the whole stepping thing. I refuse to entertain it. Now, because I respect the boundaries of my salvation.
Mm-hmm.
You understand that?
If I
go to the places where I would step, right?
Uh-huh.
And I,
uh-huh.
the spirit of that, of who I used to be is still in that place waiting on me to come back.
Mm. Mm.
So then the same spirit say, where the hole's at? Because you here.
Yeah.
No, brothers, let's just be 1,000. So why would I even put myself in a position to fight that spirit? Mm-hmm. I talked to a brother who went to the club with his wife. Same brother. Mm-hmm. A man mm-hmm. jumped, started dancing with his wife. He punched the guy in the stomach. I told him he was wrong.
Right.
He said, get off of me. Brother, he was on my brother. You had no business being there. But you,
right,
you,
right.
If you got to do that, that ain't for you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And that,
so
you know,
you gotta respect the boundaries of your salvation.
Yes, respecting the boundaries
here's the thing.
Ahead.
I'm not going to uh-huh. judge anybody else's liberty. I'm going
right.
to tell you what, I'm
but
not
you know your boundaries.
I know the boundaries of my salvation.
Yeah, yeah. And you know what you can do and what you can't do. And I think that's so important because, you know, sometimes we may not understand why people do certain things or don't do certain things, and sometimes it is due to that unspoken boundary. They may not necessarily share why, but sometimes it's due to that unspoken boundary, and I have found that on my journey
that
there's just certain lines that certain people will not cross, and to those of us looking on the outside in, it might be like, okay, well, what's the big deal? But if you don't know their journey, then you don't know why that is a boundary. That they, you know, that's a line that they will not cross.
Yeah,
that's a line that
does not
cross. Huge, huge, huge. Yeah, because that city is
I'm
just.
I'm gonna tell the truth and stay safe on this side.
Exactly. Exactly. So share with us how we can stay connected with you. This has been a wonderful conversation. I appreciate you so very much. It's been a great conversation. Share with us how the audience can stay connected with Brother Al.
Okay. Yeah, absolutely. Brother Al at Your Service on Twitter. Brother Al has a music page, but I'm Albert Bailey Jr. On regular Facebook. And you can find me on IG, Brother Al 9. That's number 9 on IG. And you can go, and I'm not unreachable. My phone number's out there. If you want to actually call and talk to me, I'm not unreachable. I'm a servant first. I will check to see if you're on folly, though. Yeah. I ain't going to lie. But other than
you're going to check it?
I'm going to check to see if you're on folly, though, if you do call. But other than that, there, I got music available. It's Brother Al on all platforms. You can go check out the single Gotta Feel. I did a collective with the label, and I got 2 songs on there. It's called I Can't Breathe, the I Can't Breathe Collective, and I contributed to that as well. So there's music out there, free and otherwise. I'm on SoundCloud, Brother Al on SoundCloud as well. So I'm here.
Amen, amen. Well, we appreciate you. And again, it's been a wonderful conversation. I feel like we have really gotten to know you in the time that we've had, you know, on the show. And I always love these conversations. Really, it's almost like as though you and I are sitting down in the living room and having a conversation, and the rest of the world just happens to be listening. You know, the rest of the world just happens to be listening and gaining insight to who Brother Al is. So thank you so much for joining us. Let's get Batman to join us to see if he has any closing remarks. And then I would ask you to close us out in prayer. Would that be okay?
All right. Yeah, appreciate you, Brother Al, and the CMG squad for, you know, for supporting Positive Power. And just want to let you know, man, thank you so much for that, for your video, for airing it on MVP with Sky. It actually made the top 10 for the upcoming episodes on Comcast in Atlanta. So we hope it spreads your message. Amen.
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 All right. I'll close this out. Okay. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we come before your throne of mercy and grace, we thank you for this time, dear Lord God, in which I could come before the people, dear Lord God, and tell the truth and stay safe, regardless, dear Father God, of what the world may do. Help us to be set apart for everything. Bless these two, dear Lord, as they go before and go before you people countless times afterwards, dear Father God, that they hold the standard of righteousness. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us right here on Positive Power 21, Batman.
Amen. We're good to go. Thank you so much, Paula G, The Voice. Thank you, Mr. Dwayne Culpepper, CMG Squad, and all the rest of the young people that's making things happen for CMG. Amen.
Amen. Thank you all so much for joining us. Until next time, embrace the journey.
You are listening to Jerry Royce Live Worldwide Podcast.
Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. Prepared for the day, evil hate my light though, huh? Persecution came when I let that light show, huh? Enemy of Christ, still he spared your life though, huh? Thief in the night, here to snuff your life though. It's a blessing, it's a blessing, it's the way that life go. Got it back tenfold, just for slanking Christ though. You would live in sacrifice, that's the way that life go. Said 1 hour at a time, marathon, tight bro. God said it any minute, ain't no scripture type.
Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show. Whole lot of sweat and tears, I ain't shed no blood though. Give my freedom to them heathens, shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord, what I need your mark for. Keep my sword in my sword, just in case the dark show.
You full again, good. That mark your friend. The beast gon' keep you fed though. You gone. You follow Christ your whole life. God. The kind of Jesus that loves your sins. He over here. You ran over there to shake the devil's hand. You sealed forever, and death won't catch you. You fight against God's plan.
I'm sealed, baby. King Jesus made me.
Whole lot of sweat and tears. I ain't shed no blood, though. Give my freedom to them heathens. Shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord. What I need your mark for? Keep my sword in my sword just in case the dark show. Whole lot of sweat and tears. I ain't shed no blood, though. Give my freedom to them heathens. Shorty, that's a no-no. Got a seal from the Lord. What I need your mark for? Keep my sword in my sword just in case the dark show.
Shot or beat with the dark pipes. They call it the dark side. This story, I call it our side. with me. I grew up on hard times, borrowing my brother's clothes, watching them part dimes, and hosts of marginalized. Using the N-word was part of our affection, a total misconception. In these streets, you always need protections. No love, no affection. So I clung to Christ, felt the resurrection. I know some folks who didn't make it. Streets is like the Matrix. The police try to chase us, take shots, swallow us whole with no chaser. Melatonin got us all asleep. We need to wake up. Some take a stand, even when they kneel. That probably went over your head like in God We Trust on a dollar bill.
We kneel because
they come back with
stumbling round and round. Flashbacks of the battleground, running from corner to corner, replaying the horror. The other forgotten, the other forgotten, the other forgotten. Silent voices filled to their minds, unable to unwind. From the place they call home, we foreclosed on our own heroes. They are the forgotten. They are the forgotten. They are the forgotten. They are the forgotten. Definitely drop the ball. Stop catching them when they fall. Nothing to eat. They are the neighbors on the streets. All for us, deep within the trenches.
And I couldn't hesitate to get my love all the way. I knew that you would be mine, baby. And I wouldn't break your heart, no way. Always pray for someone who would be the perfect fit. We can go on shopping trips who I can spend my world with. I know you are the one for me. And I never leave your heart lonely. So baby girl, what's the deal? I wanna get to know you. The world is so big, so many places I can show you. Riding camels in Dubai with you on my side. Jet skiing in blue waters to private jets when we ride. Fulfilling the wildest dreams with you on my team. That's what I do for my queen. Cause money ain't the thing, I just wanna be your man. Baby, I'm not playing, I see forever in the future. I'm praying you understand that I want you.
Do you know what today is? It's the night I make you mine, baby. Cause I'm tired of wasting time, baby. Do you know what today is? It's the night I make you mine, baby. I wish you would never find, baby.
So tell me what I gotta do just to get next to you. Even though you playing hard to get, I'm pursuing you. I knew that you would be mine, baby. And I wouldn't break your heart, no way. And I won't stop pursuing till you tell me it's on. Put your number in my phone, I hit you when I get home. I know you are the one for me. And I never leave your heart lonely. So now that it's on, I promise to treat you right. You're the woman of my dreams. I've been waiting my whole life just to find someone as special as you. I had girls in my past that don't compare to you. Cause you're a real woman with style and grace. Plus I can't wait to put a smile on your face. Now that I'm your king and you're my queen, no need to second guess love. I'ma show you what it means.
Do you know what today is? It's the night I make you mine, baby. Cause I'm tired of wasting time, baby. Today is, it's the night I make you my baby. I wish you would ever find, baby, another love like this.
We were made to be together, you
my homie, love a friend. Every time we're together, I don't want the night to end. I enjoy every moment that you in my arms. Promise to protect you, keep you safe from harm. They say a man who finds a wife finds a good thing. Well, you're my good thing, so here's your wedding ring. Cheers to a life full of love and bliss. I'ma seal it with a kiss, it gets no better than
this. 'Cause baby, you're my PYPYT. Yeah. Tell them other guys RIRIP. Yeah. Let them see the swag dripping, no IV. Nah. Baby girl, we light it up, no NYC. Yeah. Girl, you bad and you know it. All of that and you know it. Poppin' tags, yeah, we blow it. Them feelings growing. I want your heart, let me hold it. Or I'ma take it like a soul.
Oh, baby, do you know what today is? It's the night I make you mine, baby. 'Cause I'm tired of wasting time, baby. Today is, it's the night I make you my baby. Promise you will never find, baby, another love like this.
It's next on the track.
Blazing on the track, boy.
I got that all on me, I got that all on me, I got that all on me, I got that all on me. Watch me drip, watch me drip, watch me drip. Ooh, I'm so old, I got that all on me, I got that all on me, I got that all on me, I got that all on me. Watch me drip, watch me drip, watch me drip. Ooh, I'm so old, I got that all on me. You see me dripping, and that with power, filled with the spirit. The devil slipping, 'cause I'm so old, and nothing he can do, anointing all upon me. I'm a fisher, fisher of men. Throw out the word, watch God rip them in, then give him the glory for using me. This anointing cost, didn't get it for free. You see them demons fleeing. Ooh, the devil's mad. Anointed on my feet. Crush that serpent's head. Pick him up, put him down, pick him up. Pick him up, put him down, pick him up. I'm in my zone. Ain't no way that I'm letting up. I'm called to these streets to meet the people's needs. That's evangelism. Tell them to follow me as I follow Christ, God's anointed son. You want this oil? Then let him give you some. I got that all on me. 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 Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Ooh, I'm so old. I got that all on me. 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 Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Ooh, I'm so old. This all is heavy. That's all my life. It came with pain, a lot of sacrifice. You see the glory, but don't know my story. Been through hell and back. That's why I'm all is me. Now watch me flex. When them chains are breaking, that's God at work. I don't take his credit. I'm just a vessel that he can use to get his word out, spreading the good news from my mother's womb. The orbin on me, impacting lives. That's why the devil's on me. Back up off me, and let me loose. You hear them chains breaking? I got the juice. That's what I'm called to do. I've been chosen, about to wake you up. Wake up, 'cause you've been dozing. You see me glowing? That's because of him. I got the oil on me. The Lord smeared it in. I got that oil on me. 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 Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Ooh, I'm so old. I got that oil on me. 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 Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Watch me drip. Ooh, I'm so old. I'm so old.
This session is no longer being recorded.